That was an awesome ride. Hi guys, how we doing? Woo! Had a fantastic bicycle ride today. And guess what? This is going to be so fun today on our Facebook Live. We have a special guest. We have Fox Tender with us today. Come on in, guys. Oh man, had a great bicycle ride today. And it is so awesome to be back here in the studio. First, we got to get comfy.
Be happy.
Okay, like I've said before, every time you sculpt, if there's any way to be super comfortable, it is such a good thing to take off your normal shoes. These are my normal shoes, right? And let's get on some comfy shoes. These are the Sculpting slippers, and I love them. So this has been so fun. We have Fox 10 with us, like I mentioned, and Brad, our good friend of Fox 10, normally is out doing sports stories. That's what he does professionally. Has done it for many, many years. But today he's with us. He's out doing projects because the sports are closed down and all that, right? He's out doing projects, community positive stories to lift people up and lift their spirits and stuff. And that's exactly what we're trying to do here with these Facebook Lives. I realize that so many people, they're home, they're captive. They've got to figure out something to do. And so by inviting you into my studio and playing with the clay, we just have a lot of fun and it helps the time pass, and hopefully we'll learn something too, right? Today, it's going to be really fun. We are sculpting triumphant. This is the one we're going to do right here. And remember, we've had lots of pieces where we started out with a big, cool ball of clay. Can you imagine? That's exactly what we're going to be doing today, right? So, I got a couple of fun things to mention to you today. And that is about our elephant that we're going to be sculpting. Now, that is called triumphant. And many times, what I try to do is get real, real accurate with sculptures that I'm normally doing. This is an elephant that I sculpted quite a few years ago, and it's called Lord of the Jungle. And we talked about being observant in our sculpting and learning about life. Remember last time we did the cactus, and we talked about how it was hands reaching up to heaven, and that it also has a skeleton just exactly like we have skeletons. And so there's fun things as you sculpt that you can learn that just make it interesting, make life interesting. So this elephant right here was my original model. I sculpted him at the Hogel Zoo in Salt Lake City, Utah, and done a little few years ago. And remember the other animals that we sculpted from balls? We got this guy, we've got those. We even did a fat cat, right? P-H-A-T. And so now, what we're going to do, oh, I gotta mention one more thing too. If you would, all of you out there, if you would go to my YouTube channel, it's Gary Lee Price Studios. What I'm trying to do is get all of these on YouTube so that you can pull them up in the convenience of your home, your homeschool, whatever it is. When life gets going again, we can you can pull these up in your school, your school district or whatever. So that's the purpose of doing that. My goal is to get to 1,000 subscribers. So if you'll go there and subscribe, that would just be really, really cool and lots of fun for you and me. Okay, so what we're gonna do, you're gonna grab your clay, and guess what? We're gonna do exactly what we've done before. We are just going to make a ball, right? And I'm going to make this as big as I can, but still keep enough clay that I have room to add on this head, the trunk, and these great big chubby legs. So, we take our clay, we roll it around, make some room on here. And once again, remember also, Lisa has put the recipe for the homemade clay, the salt dough clay, on my FB Live Facebook post. And so you can look that up, it's on there right now. And this is the one that we did last time out of the clay. Remember the frog? That was a lot of fun. It's dried out pretty well now. See? And like we mentioned before too, you can take your acrylic paint and paint them any colors you want. That would be another thing. If you guys can all send me pictures, tag me on what you've sculpted today. It's so fun. I love seeing what you have done, what you have created. Okay, so we have our first ball. Everybody at home, do you have your big ball ready? Okay, now let's make a smaller ball. So we're gonna set that one there. We're gonna go ahead and we'll make another ball, and guess what? It's for Triumphant's head right there. So we'll go ahead, make another ball like that, right? Let's just go ahead and stick that on there. Stick that head on there. And then remember our other favorite shape that we love to do? We love to make our snakes, right? So let's go ahead and roll our clay and make us some snakes. And you can imagine what we're gonna use them for. Remember how when we were sculpting our hands and our synergy and our cactus, we made the snakes? So we're just gonna repeat that shape again. And so guess what? We have two front legs, we have two hind legs, and we have this cool trunk right here. So we are going to divide this into four. And we'll take our, what's our favorite tool? Remember that? It's our popsicle sticks, right? These are the coolest little units. So we're gonna cut this in half, and then we're gonna cut it in half again. Okay, now we have two front legs and two hind legs, and where, there he is. I've got so many sculptures on here, they're starting to hide and lose themselves. So what we're gonna do here, we're gonna look at this guy. It's always fun to have things right next to you when you're sculpting them. We're gonna put a front leg on there. We're gonna grab another leg here. And we're gonna take a little bit off there. Now those two legs are pretty close together. So we're gonna put those on there just like that. Okay, does that kind of look like that? We'll squish him out here a little bit on the bottom, like that. We've already got his head on there, right? Now let's go around to the other side and let's make these just a little bit longer, because see, they go all the way back to his pelvis, and then they have a knee joint just like us. Remember, like we talked about, whether you're a frog, whether you're an elephant, whatever you are, all of the muscles and bones are the same. They're just in kind of different places here and there. So we'll go ahead and take our back leg, stick it onto the pelvis there, and have it come around just about to the front leg like that, right? Does that look like about that? There's our knee joint right there. Okay, and now we'll take the other one. We've got to have four legs on there, right? This elephant's eventually, when he's tired of sitting down, he's got to get up and take off, right? So we'll do the same thing there. We'll just stick that leg on there. Okay, does that kind of look like this? See, we're slowly getting there, right? Actually, we're getting there really quickly. That's what's fun about this. I try to make it really simple so that it's not a complicated, long and drawn out situation, but rather it can be fun. And you can make it as detailed as you want later on. But for now, I like to keep these sessions to about 30 minutes so that we can have time to, you know, get into it a little bit, but not have it go crazy. Okay, so we basically got him, right? that part at least. Now we get to have fun with a trunk. Now we're, one of the cool designs with this is we're going to be doing the ears. And so we are going to add our trunk so that you can see how we're doing there. Got this cool trunk. We'll just stick it on there like that. And then the trunk will curl up here. And then we'll have it shoot out here like that. Okay, we'll put a little flat spot on there. How's that? Does that kind of look like it? Right, we're coming along. Looks like we might have to squish the head a little bit more. Coming in there like that. See, we're getting a little closer, right? Isn't this fun?
Awesome.
This is one of the funnest pieces I think I've ever sculpted, called Triumphant. It's the whole idea that, yeah, we always go through crazy things in our life, but we can also be triumphant with it. Okay? So we got that. Oh, look, we gotta have part of the mouth here. So let's go ahead and grab us a piece of clay. And we'll maybe make us kind of a, like a little triangle, kind of like our jaw right here, right? That's his jaw. We'll go ahead and stick that on there. Oh, look at that. Look how much that added to it, right? So we'll stick that there. Let's make us a couple of little snakes. And we'll go ahead and make his tusks, right? So we'll stick that right there. There goes our good friend Brad. He's had a lot of fun filming us today, and now he's going to go to a cool person's home and film them live while they're sculpting the elephant. We have some neighbors just down the road, and so that's gonna be fun. Okay, so we got our tusks on there, right? And now let's make us a couple of flat pieces of clay. Grab this one. I'll add a little bit more clay there. Let's make these big, beautiful ears, right? This happens to be an African elephant. That's why the ears are so big. And that piece over there, the original elephant that I did, see how big those ears are? Now, if we were sculpting an Indian elephant, the ears are just about half that size. I would have had to have made them, you know, maybe clear up here. But I love the design of these great big ears, all the better to hear you with, right, my dear? So we are going to be sculpting some big ears. And just like that, just like our elephant here, let's go ahead and stick them on. Okay, does that kind of look like a great big ear? I think it kind of does. What do you think? How is yours coming at home? And you know, I will be absolutely fascinated to see how many different colors some of these elephants turn out to be. It's been so fun. So look, somebody, our awesome grandson Hudson, no, this was Talon, did the hands of responsibility out of pink. Isn't that cool? And he did the arch that represented the world. Remember our arch on the great big one here? Which when it goes out, it represents the whole world. He did it out of green clay. Isn't that cool? And our other little guy, Hudson, he did it out of these colors, right? Isn't that fun? I mean, it's just so creative. Or you can do it like I'm doing and just do one color. But I can't wait to see if some of you have done other colors, what they turn out to be. I know our grandson, Kaysen, he did a frog out of like orange and purple and green, all kinds of fun ones. So I'll take a little piece here. See this fun ridge right here? That's kind of the, look at our ear. See how they have kind of a ridge there that holds up our ear? Just like that, that is that. Maybe if I turn this way, compare my ear to my cool triumphant's ear, right? See, they have the same things there. So we'll take this little piece here and we'll add it to that part. Okay, does that kind of look like that? Oh yeah, coming right along. Okay, so let's turn him around. Let's get another piece of our clay, squish it out like that. We want to make the ear about the same size as that one, so we'll take a little bit off there. If you wanted to, you could make one ear big and one little. I don't know, whatever you want. You are the artist. You get to decide what you are creating. And like I mentioned before, we could have 20 people in here and I could tell everybody, I'd say, go ahead and sculpt triumphant. There wouldn't be any two alike because we're all so unique and we all do everything from our own perspectives and our own filters. And I think that's what's beautiful. Once again, we are individual, unique miracles. Nobody exactly like us. Okay, so I've sculpted an ear just a little bit bigger, and I kind of want it to be the same size. So I'm gonna go ahead and take a little bit off, make it kind of round again. Okay, now we'll turn our guy over here and we'll stick it on about the same as the other one. Okay, how's that? We'll blend that in just a little bit. We'll shape it around there. We'll grab that piece of clay again and put that little part of the ear right there, right? We gotta have something to hold it up. Otherwise our ears are gonna go beep. We want them to hold up. So we'll go ahead, stick that on there, keep that ear held up, we'll blend it in a little bit. Okay, let's see if we have the other side. Oh yeah, yeah, it's coming along. It's getting pretty close to that, right? Okay, we can have our tusk up there. We have our kind of like a water spout, right? Can you imagine if this was a fountain and you had water going inside it and it shot out there and make a great big umbrella of water? Wouldn't that be fun? Okay, let's see here. I think we're coming along pretty good. I want to add a little bit of cheek on here. So I'm going to grab a little piece of clay and stick a little bit on there, right? And I want to take my popsicle stick and maybe I want to see that cool tongue. See how his tongue is stout? Whenever we open our mouth a lot of times, right? We have our tongue sticking out there. So let's go ahead. We can stick a tongue in there. We can flatten it out with our popsicle stick. Squish it there. Squish it down a little bit. Squish it. Ah, say ah. And there we have our elephant with the tongue. Okay, now this is gonna be cool. We've got, our elephant's got a C, right? So let's put a little bit of a eyeball orbit on there. We've gotta have some place for the eyeball to fit, right? See that right there? That is called, let's see, right here's called the zygomatic arch. Right there, and this is called the brow ridge. See, we're all the same, kinda. So let's go ahead and get a brow ridge on there, a little zygomatic arch on there. And then, remember before we talked about sculpting, that a lot of times it's just sculpting light. And so I'm gonna turn this around like this, and we wanna sculpt that eyeball. So take something, maybe a toothpick or another tool, and kind of poke it in there a little bit and make a cute little eyeball. How's that? Is that looking pretty good? Something like that. And see, if you don't like it, you can always just squish it again and you can make another one. Just like that. See how easy that is? Or if somebody wanted to and they wanted him to really, really have kind of like frog eyes, you could stick a piece of clay on there and have him really be able to see, right? Do that, and then you could take your popsicle stick or something and go like that. I mean, that it's unlimited as to what you can do. Now, one thing we cannot forget right here, right? An elephant has to have a tail that they can swish off some of the flies, right? So we'll go ahead and make us a little snake. We'll get our elephant down here. We'll add a little tail there. Maybe like that. Stick a little bit more clay on here. And add a little bit. And remember, like we talked about too, what are some of your very, very best tools? It's not the popsicle stick. It's not the toothpicks. It's these guys right here. They're your digits. We have 10 of them, 10 tools you have right there. So we can just go for it. We can sculpt this like crazy. I'm gonna go ahead and switch out that frog eye, and I'm gonna go ahead and sculpt another elephant eye on there to match. Once again, I kinda wanna match this one right here. I want it to be a happy eye, and I want my elephant to be happy, so he's gonna have a big smile there. Got that tongue sticking out. The other side, we're gonna put a big smile on him right there. Because I want my elephant to be a happy, triumphant elephant. And we're about there. Oh, now this is one of the coolest parts. And this is with your popsicle stick. This is so cool. In doing the research, I found out that elephants also have 5 toes, just like we do. So watch this. You take your popsicle stick, and you go like that. Does that look like an elephant toenail or what? Isn't that cool? So we take that, we go ahead and stick another one in there like that. Is that looking just like that? Isn't that awesome? And we can do the same thing here with the back toenail. Now here we'll be able to see the bottom also. So we can push that in there like that, and then we can push that like that. So there's our elephant toenail, just like that one. Let's go ahead and make another one. Go ahead and make another one on the top here. See, that's the funnest part of sculpting the whole elephant, I think, is making those toenails. Let's go ahead and make a couple more out here. All right, how's that? Should we make some more here? See how quick he can make those? Doot, doot, doot. Doot, doot. There we go. I think we're pretty close, don't you? Can you see anything else that we've got to add to him? Let's see, we could make maybe his knee joints just a little bit better. So we could do that if we wanted to, not necessary. Remember, the coolest thing with sculpture, it's not all the detail. You know, a lot of people, when they start drawing or sculpting, they think that they've got to get all the detail, all the hair, the eyes just perfect. It's not. It's the basic shape. I call it the gestalt. It's a German word and it means form. And so it's the basic shape, right? We have a basic ball there. I mean, that's all it is. And that's what makes it fun. That's what makes this piece fun. So there we go. I think we've got it. Another project. I think this is number, what, Lisa?
Boy, 4 or 5? Might be 5 or 6.
Might be 5, but there we go. Now, I think what we might do next time, speaking of elephants, you guys are going to love this. I did another, I love elephants. They're so cool. What they symbolize and what they represent about memory and community. Elephants love to be together and they have this beautiful community. We are going to, Lisa, come over here for a second. This is another elephant. Mm-hmm. that I did. It's called, you're going to love this name. It's the coolest name, Buddha Font. It's a Buddha elephant meditating, right? And yet it's an elephant, so Buddha Font. So maybe next time we'll sculpt my Buddha Font. It'll kind of be the same thing, only instead of having a ball, look at that. That's like a perfect pear shape. So we could do the pear, and then his ears will be sticking out. So we'll have those sticking out like that. We'll make those same ears, but we'll just put them out. We'll have that cool trunk, that trunk. And then maybe we'll put a necklace on him, just like that one. This is the one in bronze, and then this is one in cast marble. So that could be really, really fun. Should we do that next time? I have so many projects lined up, we could probably do 100 of them. I could probably do one every day, but I want to space it out just a little bit so that you have a day in between to work on your projects, maybe come up with your own projects. If you have a suggestion for me that you would like to sculpt, go ahead and Facebook me, let me know. When you go ahead and send me a picture, tag me on the picture of the sculpture that you made, and then let me know, what would you like to sculpt? So I think we've got it. Let's get out of here again. I'm gonna go for another little bicycle ride and keep sculpting, have lots of fun, be creative. Remember, every child is born an artist. The challenge is, how do we remain an artist once we grow up? Remember those creative powers. Those creative powers help us solve our problems. So there you go, have fun. See you Wednesday. Oh yeah. I think I'll grab my chili pepper face mask here. It's kind of fun to go around the neighborhood with my face mask on. I get lots of waves from people, and I always love to wave at people. It's so fun. So here we go. Let's go do it.
Here's a little song I wrote. You might want to sing it note for note. Don't worry.
Big thanks today to Brad Gass, Fox 10 Phoenix. Love you, Brad.
Thank you, guys.